Hello everyone, it's Sabrina again from Saab Soaps. Today, Mr. Saab, or you can call him James, we are going to make camouflage or camo soap. It's scented with essential oils, Virginia Cedarwood, Spanish sage, and lemongrass. I'm using my favorite bastille recipe, so it's olive oil, coconut oil, and cocoa butter. And everything is ready to go at room temperature, so we're ready to go. Beyond that, it is an incredibly frigid night in Canada. And just to, I was thinking earlier, it was funny because my hubby and I here, the one taking the film, we're just that Canadian that we're walking out at, 9 o'clock at night in minus 40 degree weather to get poutine. And it was delicious, by the way. So because it's cold, it's not even room temperature, it's the water, everything is cold. So, it's going to take a little longer for it all to set up, I'm thinking, but we do want it to be fairly thick, because we want to be able to place the colors into the mold and have it set in thick splotches. And that's where James is going to take over that part of the video. I think that's thick enough for us to play with our colors. So we've debated back and forth on what colors that we're going to put in this. We've decided that we're going to put a light green, a dark green, a light brown, and a dark brown and black. So when we go with the light green, we'll try to go fairly light, but we decided not to go with the cream color in there this time. So get ours out. Oops, we're going with 5 colors this time. Get my paint buckets. Should be able to fill it like that, so for each one. And whatever's left in the bucket, we'll turn black. The red bucket. We think that look about right. Or the other one more. So if there's a lot of shadow, it is late, so we have a few lamps to help with the light. There we go. 5 buckets for 5 colors. You know, so. Alright. So we're gonna, I guess we'll start with the brown. Now this is cocoa powder that I mixed with olive oil earlier, and it's pretty thick at this point. I think the cold temperatures are really good. So this one we're only going to put a little bit, and this one we're going to put a little more. That should turn that a nice brown color, but we'll see first when we blend it in. But maybe before we blend the brown, we should probably blend the green. Now the green is very touchy. This needs some chrome oxide, so it's basically green rust. I have to laugh about that. But you need so little to turn. So let's go with that one first to see if it's too dark, and that way we can put even less in this one here if it's too much. You want one to be fairly light. What do you think? You hardly turn at all, eh? A little darker?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, put my hair in there always. Rapunzel. Just a little bit. A little bit. A bit exuberant with it. Maybe just a touch more?
Yeah.
How about what's on the spoon? Is that too much?
No, it should be enough.
Camo is James's masterpiece. So he gets the call on the color. Maybe two front. What do you think? I think that's a nice light green.
Yeah.
First I have it on my glove. Knife too. Yep, I think that's a nice light green, and we'll aim for darker for the next one. Yes. I don't need to spoil it yet. Okay. Now, do we want to add a touch of
charcoal?
Yes. Ooh, that's nice.
That's already a good start.
Yeah, so little needed. Absolutely. Let's get this off my glove before everything I touch is green. Green rust everywhere. Now, in this bucket here, this little bin, I have mixed charcoal with water, so it's very thick. Only one drop, I think. Let's see how that goes. Do we get one more drop?
Yeah, one more.
Charcoal down for now, because let's deal with the brown.
I was going to say, you're probably going to need some charcoal for the one brown.
Well, we'll see how dark it goes first, because it should darken as well. I think we might need a little more in this one. Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Sorry guys, I'm left-handed and I was in the way. Well, this one's turning a nice chocolate. Let's see how dark that goes. Nope, it needs more. More chocolate. And this is what I love about the about using natural colors is that you can eat it if you want to. If you want to have some. This chocolate. Right, so at this point, we just want it to thicken up enough so that we can spoon it into the mold and have it stay nice and thick chunks of color, because it is like a camouflage versus a stripe. So we are going to leave these for a few minutes. We'll let them set up, and then we'll be right back. So before I let it thicken up too much, I realized that I hadn't actually added the fragrance, the essential oil. So this is going to thin it a little bit, which is unfortunate, but we can always let it sit again for another couple minutes. It has only been about 2.5 minutes since I said I was going to leave it. It hasn't been a full amount of time or anything, so I'm just trying to divvy this up between them all. And again, this is the essential oils. So frankly, this is an all-natural soap using oxides, chocolate, and chocolate pepper. And I know that oxides are created in the lab these days, but they are still the same base element that's found in nature. There's no extra additives or anything else to it. It is just the powdered rust. It's the same rust that we use in our makeup. Alright, so we've thickened this up enough that we can spoon it into the mold. But James is going to do this part. Well, good morning, everybody. I'm trying something new today. I have set up a tripod for my camera, so I don't have to have... It's actually for my tablet, which is why I had a problem, because it didn't work with my tripod. So we're all ready to cut the camo. I thought you'd actually want to watch me unwrap it too, because oh, look at that. So we made this last night. It has definitely not been 24 hours. It's been about 12 actually. Now, many moons ago, I stopped using full water. I use a water discount now. Sorry about my voice, guys. I am getting over a cold for like the last 4 weeks. So anyways, I use a water discount. It's the 66-33, or basically 2-to-1 ratio with my liquid and lye. And so my soap does cure a lot faster. I have a lot less issues with with ash. And I just find that, of course, I like that my soap cures faster. But these will, let's see the other side. These will darken as they cure. With the water discount, it usually takes 4 weeks maximum, depending on the fragrance. Sometimes fragrance does, cause it to take a little longer, I find. Sometimes. Sometimes the essential oils. There was my Breathe Easy Bar, which is eucalyptus, lavender, and rosemary. That bar actually took 6 weeks before I was willing to take it off the curing rack and wrap it up. Look at that. It's just beautiful. Indeed. So it's a beautiful freezing day again today. It is January in Canada. Like I mentioned, I believe, before. For those that don't know me. And it's another snow day today. A lot of schools are closed. I'm sure the city buses are running, but... And it smells divine, because of course, as I mentioned, I do have a cold, so cutting this sage and cedarwood soap is definitely doing fantastic things for my sinuses, I'll tell you that. Look at the camouflage. I just love the way James lays it in. He does the pink camouflage as well. James helps me with a lot of soaps lately. I think he likes it. Wonderful. 8. Pick you up and move you around here. Alright, so there we have it. Camouflage. Okay. Thanks for watching Sad Soaps. Have a great day and stay warm.